intimidating road venues in college football, thanks to the 12th man. And now the coin toss, and it's presented by Nissan, innovation that excites. Oregon is kicking off first, and we're ready to get this game underway. Sends it sailing downfield. Quarterback brings his troops out onto the field for the first drive of the game. They have to watch the play clock here. And he carries the ball for a nice gain. Hicks gets 6 yards on the carry.
That'll make it second and four.
Second and four. Ball on their own 31. Around the 27-yard line. Where in the world was he going on that run?
Well, that's a good question. I thought for a while he got his directions messed up.
From their own 27-yard line, third down. Nearly intercepted.
It's always big when you can get in the way of a pass on third down because you know the offense is bringing it. Fourth down.
Hunter awaits the snap. He really got a hold of that one. Calls for the fair catch.
Fair catch made at the 27-yard line.
So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field.
Watch 36. 36 to Mike. Down. Wait, alert, alert. Ruin, ruin.
Motion, motion, motion.
Looking for the corner. And they get nice yardage on that run.
Call it a game of 7 yards. That'll bring up second and three.
Check, check. Orange three. Orange three.
He's taken down right around the 48-yard line.
You talk about a dual threat guy. This guy can hurt you in the air or on the ground.
And down he goes at the 50-yard line.
That's good for
around the 48-yard line. They'll bring him down at about the 37-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
Easy, easy. X7. Blue 20.
Run, 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 run.
to the run game, and this time he's met immediately. Second and 13 coming up here. Ball on the 40-yard line. And he just gets rid of it. And this is the eighth play of the drive. The offense going to try to open this field up, coming out at a five-wide set. And the defense counters with their dime look. Great concentration to haul it in. Tackle made around the 30-yard line.
I know the defense would have liked to have prevented such a big game, but the important thing is that they held and brought up fourth down.
So at the end of one quarter, no score here. Set to resume action here in the second quarter, and we've got a tight ball game. Oregon is looking to go up by three. It has the distance, and he got it. Is lined up to kick this one off.
Number 20.
He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Quick pass, tight end, and he wasn't ready for it.
Terrific coverage, and when you clog up passing lanes like that, you can force a quarterback to make some poor decisions. Almost got themselves a turnover, too.
From their own 25-yard line, second down. Gets rid of it quickly, and that was almost picked.
Boy, this is a great play by the safety to be able to be in a position to make this play, but he's got to be able to hold on to the football. You know, he's a big, physical, athletic guy, but you've got to be able to secure a football and make a big play when it presents itself.
Hey, alert 48. Hey,
we're going back to
48 right now. Let's go.
Flag 98.
Flag. He chucks it downfield. That close to being intercepted.
Johnson, the intended receiver on the play. That'll make it fourth and 10.
The defense looks like they're going to send in the cavalry on this one. He punts it away, and it's a great kick. Signals for a fair catch.
Fair catch made at the 26-yard line.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Oregon is up a field goal. Strike to his receiver, no good. From their own 26-yard line, it's second down. But they're going to lose yards. He would tackle immediately. He wants it all. No, incomplete.
Manning, the intended receiver on the play. Fourth down.
Joseph to punt.
Yeah.
They'll bring him down at the 46-yard line. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. And he's tackled at the 46. That makes it second and two.
Jack, Jack, Thunder! Thunder! Ready! Jack,
he fires this one. And he's got it. And he's taken down at the 8.
Well, I tell you, these guys have some skill players who can make things happen. They picked up an enormous amount of real estate on that play.
First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line.
Watch the pass. Hey, alert 48. Hey, go back to 48 right now.
Let's go.
Hot, Black 98.
Brought down after a nice run up the middle.
Good for a gain of 6 yards. That brings up second and goal.
They line up in the jumbo set. Touchdown.
This is what an offensive lineman hopes for. An opportunity to impose his will on the defense.
Tacks on the extra point. A four-play, 54-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points. So the score now, 7-3. Maxwell gets set to kick this one away. Nice kick, plenty of distance. He's to the 20, and he's taken down at the 22.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions.
Brought down at the 24-yard line.
Call it a gain of 2 yards. That makes it second and 8.
Scrambling around. Quarterback's going to run it, and he's got room to work. And they make the stop at the 41-yard line. They'll get the first down.
He made the correct decision to tuck it and go.
The Ducks will use their first time out of the half. From their own 41-yard line. First down. Slings it. He's tackled at the 33. Oregon's going to have to use their second time out of the half. Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here.
makes it first and goal.
It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here.
Let's go, Stan! Make some noise!
And two sacks!
Throws it and is caught for the touchdown. That play ever developed nicely?
Well, it's all about the receiver on this play. He beat his man off the line and then ran a perfect route. All he had to do after that was make the catch.
Trying to go up by three, they'll kick the extra point. He makes the PAT. A five-play, 77-yard drive, and they get it in for seven.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
Six points and a pretty display of passing was a result of their last drive. Kirk, do you expect the defense to take a different approach here?
When this quarterback is on, he is on. It already seems like whatever this defense is trying just isn't working. But maybe if they add just a little bit more pressure, then they might be able to force him into a mistake.
Defensive dominance through two quarters of play. We go to halftime. Oregon leads 10-7. Great first half and a tight ball game, and we're set to start quarter number three. He just drills this one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
Well, this is a very competitive game. Just when you think one team has gained the advantage or the momentum, the other team comes fighting back, and it's going back and forth. This is almost like a basketball game.
So now both teams come trotting back out onto the field. Oregon has a three-point lead. He's taken down right around the 34.
Long with the tackle at the 34-yard line. That brings up second and one.
Watch 36. 36 to Mike.
Got some open field. Makes it out to about the 49.
First down.
Kill, kill, kill!
Run the three!
Fires out to his receiver. Good open field tackle.
Good job, good job.
On the tackle at the 33-yard line.
Too easy, too easy.
That makes it first and 10.
Kill, kill, kill!
Some daylight. Makes it out to about the 23.
They're eating up a lot of field on this drive. I'm really impressed with their ball control.
Quick out to his receiver. And that sets them up with a first and goal.
Keith makes the tackle at the 5-yard line. That makes it first and goal.
Kill, kill, kill!
Looks to a receiver, touchdown!
A good football team has to consistently be able to capitalize when they're in the red zone.
splits the uprights with the extra point. They line up to kick this one away. Excellent kick. He's to the 20. Makes it to the 22-yard line.
Kickoff returns 22 yards.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. They come out in a goal line set. And he carries the ball for a nice gain.
That's a gain of four on the play. That makes it second and six.
It's second down, six to go. Ball on the 26-yard line.
Hey, alert 48. Hey, come on, Mike, 48 right now. Let's go.
Ready. Red 18.
And down he goes at the 37.
Any offense is predicated on being able to move efficiently like this.
They're about 4 yards away here on second down. They're packed in tight on the line. And they get nice yardage on that run. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 49. Runs outside for a nice game.
Called a gain of 5 yards. That brings up second and five.
And this is still anyone's ball game as we head into the final quarter of play. Oregon's got a 10-point lead. Welcome back to the action here as we resume play here in quarter number four. Less than 3 minutes in the game.
Red 85. Red 85.
Pulls it in and he could score. And a huge touchdown play. That was a big, big score and it makes it a one possession game, but we've still got a lot of football left. Here's the point after to try to cut this to a 3-point game. And he hits the PAT. So a 6-play, 77-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown.
Fred, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
So our score, 17-14. Manning fields it at the 1. He's to the 20, and he makes it out to about the 21-yard line.
So early in the fourth quarter in a very, very tight football game, and the game could hinge on this possession. He gets hit out of bounds at the 28-yard line.
Game seven on the play. That'll bring up second and three.
Now he's scrambling. They'll make the sack. Just over 2 minutes in the game. Zips it to the back. That screen play gets him a yard at the most.
It's a nice play by the defense to shut down all the lanes, so this halfback wasn't able to make anything happen on that play.
And watch out. They're going to bring the heat right here. He's tackled at the 43. Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game.
Ready?
Tackle made around the 50-yard line. He's at the 40. Tackle at the 30-yard line. From the 30-yard line. First down. And he's tackled at about the 27-yard line.
That'll make it second and seven.
Just over a minute left. Makes the catch, and look out. He steps up around the 17-yard line.
There's very good chemistry between these two. They like to run through all their routes before the game. And I have to say, they look sharp before this one even started.
From the 17-yard line, it's first down. Quick strike, and he drops it.
Terrific coverage. And when you clog up passing lanes like that, you could force a quarterback to make some poor decisions. Almost got themselves a turnover, too.
Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 17. Fires out to his wideout. Big play, and it's first and goal.
That'll move the chains for another Texas A&M. First down.
First and goal from the one, looking to punch this one in. They line up in the jumbo set.
We own them.
Watch two, watch two.
68. Flag, 68. Hunt, hunt.
Motion.
Touchdown, and they take the lead. think the way that offense dug deep to get the lead here this late in the fourth quarter, that might translate over and give enough emotion to their defense to win the football game. And he adds the extra point. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Manning fields at the goal line. Gets to about the 24-yard line. Well, this is the chance. Late in the fourth quarter, they're behind, but they've got an opportunity now to come back and win it. Tries to scramble, but he's sacked. The Ducks taking their first time out of the half.
Second and 15.
From their own 19-yard line. Second down.
Here we go. Green, nine.
Kill.
Three.
Setting up blockers. A running back's got it on the screen. They'll bring him down at the 17-yard line. Oregon's going to have to use their second time out of the half. Screen here, and the halfback's got it. Well, a lot of frustration by that offense, but you've got to give the defense credit for coming up with a stop in this quarter in a game this close. Fourth down, and the offense is still on the field. So the big blow comes from the defense. They come up with the stop of the day, and that'll ice this football game. And they're going to have to give the ball back after going for it on fourth and long.
Not much you can do there. You got to go for it and give yourselves a chance.
9 times out of 10, the defense will make a stop on that play. But, you know, based on the situation, this offense did have to go for it. We are late in the fourth quarter in a very important and a very tight football game. And who's going to come to the forefront? We'll see who's got the most leadership. He's tackled at the 17. Oregon will take their final timeout.
Of 1 yard on the play. That'll bring up second and 12.
The 10 gains his way to the 7-yard line. So the Aggies are going to call their second timeout. Brought down at the 11-yard line. A great one to win, a really tough one to lose. 21-17, Aggies.
And the Ducks, 17.
That does it for this edition of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.